They probably know my name, Meek, Millie, Flo is Flames. Plus, I got that fireman, Puffers call me Lil Wayne. And I got a little gang, hoes full of niggas swag, trying to fucking suck me just so they can get they niggas mad.
Robert rihmeek Williams, better known as Meek Mill, is a popular American hip-hop recording artist who embarked on his musical journey through rap battles, and today he is one of the richest and popular musicians. His rap group, the Bloodhounds, became a rage in the rap circles across America, and Meek achieved quite a name in the early phases of his career owing to his rap group. And in this video, we'll be taking a dive into the life, career, feuds, controversies, and other personal stuff you want to know about the rapper. But first, I want you to take 1 second out of your precious time to leave me a like on this video. Drop a comment in the comment section below telling me what issues in the world of rap you want to see me make videos about. Once you've done that, go ahead and smash that red subscribe button and turn on the notification bell icon right beside it so that you'll get notified by YouTube when I drop your requested video here on the Hip Hop X YouTube channel. And now that I know you've liked, commented, subscribed, and turned on notifications, let's take a full dive into the controversial life of Meek Mill. The first big break for Mill came in 2008 when he signed a deal for his very first recording by the Atlanta-based rapper T.I. Meek made several switches in his career from label to label in order to find the best workplace and creative freedom. He moved on to Rick Ross's My Back Music Group, the label which later released Mill's debut studio album titled Dreams and Nightmares, which perfectly exhibited the powerhouse of talent that Meek was. Soon after, he released his second studio album, Young and Gettin' It, which debuted at number 2 on the Billboards and opened a grand new world of fame and fortune for Meek. He embarked into the music business through his own label, Dream Chaser Records, and now he's promoting the young talent through it. Meek Mill was born Robert rihmeek Williams on May 6, 1987 in South Philadelphia, the son of Kathy Williams and her husband. Meek has a sister named Nashima Williams. His father died when he was just 5, apparently during an attempted robbery. His uncle Robert described Meek Mill's father as a black sheep of the family. The death of his father devastated Meek emotionally, and his family became poor with no sources of income. Kathy grew up in poverty, and her mother died when she was young. After the death of his father, Meek made a move to North Philadelphia along with his mother and sister in pursuit of a better life. They rented a 3-bedroom apartment, which they were barely able to afford, and in order to make the ends meet, his mother cut hair and shoplifted every now and then. Meek was a shy and quiet kid during his childhood, and he saw his mother going through a lot of hardships in order to support his family. He, however, became close to one of his father's very close friends who happened to be a famed DJ in the Philadelphia underground music scene. Meek accompanied him often and was severely influenced by the rush that music brought into his veins, and that was when he started thinking of making a career in music. Mills became active in the underground rap battle scene and worked on his lyrics at nights. The Bloodhounds was formed when he and two of his best friends came together and started burning their songs into the CDs, and kept their dreams alive throughout their teenage. They bought blank CDs and jewel cases at Kinko's, encouraging friends to burn them with the group songs and distribute them. When he was 18, while walking to a corner store armed, Meek Mill was arrested for illegally possessing a firearm and was beaten up by the police. Because of the beating, his lips and both eyes became swollen and one of his braids was ripped out. He was charged with assaulting the police officer after two black cops gave a statement against him in the case, saying he chased them down with a gun and tried to kill them. He was then placed on probation. The Bloodhounds lasted long enough to release 4 mixtapes. In 2008, Mill released his 4th solo mixtape, Flamers 2, Hottest in the City, which spawned the promotional singles I'm So Fly, Prawly, and Hottest in the City. Flamers 2 caught the attention of Charlie Mack, founder and president of 215 Affiliated Records. Mack was so impressed with Mill that he immediately signed him to his management company. His early experience with rap battles had made Meek Mills quite popular, and he grabbed the eyeballs of many prolific names from the music industry. One among them was T.I., who was heavily influenced by Meek's solo mixtapes, The Real Me, The Real Me 2, and Flamers. He was also impressed by Mill and offered him an opportunity to travel, to meet with him and Warner Bros. Records. Within a week, both record companies offered him a deal. Although he was offered other record deals, Mill felt collaborating with T.I. was an opportunity of a lifetime, and thus chose his label. But their association never quite became successful initially, as both the rappers found themselves in legal troubles which delayed the deal. Mill was arrested, charged with gun and drug possession, and ordered to serve 7 months in prison. He was released in early 2009. Once Meek moved past the hearings and accusations, he released Flamers 2.5, The Preview, and Flamers 3, The Wait Is Over, to taste his very first widespread mainstream success. Two tracks in particular, Make 'Em Say and Rose Red, were massive hits and furthered the fan following of Mills. In 2010, Meek released his seventh mixtape titled Mr. California, which he mentioned was quite personal to him on so many levels. The mixtape featured his promotional single, Rose Red, which was later remixed with additional verses from fellow American rappers T.I., Rick Ross, and Beto. Rick Ross contributed his verse after he was visiting Philadelphia and asked his Twitter followers who he should collaborate with. Meek Mill was the overwhelming response. The remix was included on Mill's following mixtape, Mr. Philadelphia. Due to Mill's and Grand Hustle label boss T.I.'s respective legal troubles, Mill was never able to release an official album under Grand Hustle, and they parted ways in 2010. The big shot of American rap scene, Rick Ross, came to know of him through the mixtapes and signed him on for his record label Maybach Music Group. And the association led Meek to get a chance to release two singles, I'm a Boss and Tupac Back, for the company's album Self-Made Volume 1. Meek got a chance to show up in the album a total of 9 times, and in the two more compilation albums, Self-Made Volume 2 and Self-Made Volume 3, Meek got enough of the limelight to prove that he has some serious talent. The song was later remixed, featuring T.I., Birdman, Lil Wayne, DJ Khaled, Swizz Beatz, and Rick Ross. The remix charted on the Billboard Hot 100 and peaked at number 51, becoming Mill's most successful single at the time. In August 2011, Mill released Dreamcatchers, a well-received mixtape featuring his urban hit House Party, and guest appearances from Rick Ross, Yo Gotti, and Beanie Siegel, among others. His 3-volume mixtape series, Dreamcatchers, became a talk of the town, and the second one of the series, Dreamcatchers Volume 2, became the most downloaded mixtape of all times. All this success encouraged Meek to release his debut studio album, Dreams and Nightmares, in 2012, which received slow acclaim in the beginning, but eventually went on to win the gold certificate 3 years later. On May 10th, it was announced Meek Mill signed with Roc Nation Management. On June 19th, 2012, Amen, originally included on Dream Chasers 2, was released as the lead single from Mill's debut studio album. Before releasing his debut studio album, Dreams and Nightmares, Mill received co-signs from both Mariah Carey and Nas, with him appearing on Carey's 2012 single, Triumphant, Get 'Em, and the latter stating, I got my eyes on him, he's the next one to take this shit over. The album was released on October 30th, 2012. Following an album release party in Philadelphia, Mill was detained by Philadelphia police after a car in which he was riding in was pulled over. No charges were filed, and Mill was released from custody. The album debuted at number 2 on the US Billboard 200 chart, with the first week sales of 165,000 copies. In its second week, the album sold 41,000 more copies, dropping 6 spots on the chart to number 8. Mill released the third installment of the Dream Chasers series, Dream Chasers 3. The mixtape featured guest appearances from Rick Ross, Akon, Future, Waka Flocka Flame, Whale, Trina, and Jada Kiss, among others. The mixtape was scheduled to be released on May 6, 2013. However, he had announced that it would be pushed back, eventually to be released on September 29, 2013. In November 2013, Mill announced that he was halfway finished with his second studio album. On March 8, 2014, Mill announced that the album would be titled Dreams Worth More Than Money. Mill's album, Dreams Worth More Than Money, which was released on June 28, 2015, topped the Billboard 200 as of the issue dated July 18, 2015. For his second studio album, Meek was highly hopeful, but things went sour as he was jailed owing to a parole violation, and that delayed the release. He went on to release the album in 2015, and in the first week of its release alone, it sold 246,000 copies. Meek once again stepped into the mixtape arena and dropped Dream Chasers 4 in October 2016 with the announcement of Dream Chasers 4.5. On July 21st, 2017, Meek Mill released his third studio album titled Wins and Losses. Mill announced his fourth album, Championships, which was released on November 30th. The album received positive reviews from critics and debuted atop the US Billboard 200, selling 229,000 album equivalent units in its first week. In June 2020, Mill released his protest song, Other Side of America, amid the protests following the killing of George Floyd. On November 20th, 2020, Meek returned with the 4-track EP, Quarantine Pack, which features rappers 42 Doug, Vory, and Lil Durk, who also appear in the video for the track, Pain Away. In October 2020, Meek said he had plans on releasing an album before the end of the year. While that wasn't exactly the case, the rapper had been spotting shooting music videos in and around Philadelphia, so it's clear new music is definitely on the way. Let's have a look at the rapper's record label and how he started. On October 26, 2012, Meek Mill announced the launch of his own record label imprint, Dream Tracers Records, with the flagship artists Louis V. Guda, Lee Mazin, and Goldie. In April 2013, he also signed 17-year-old Louisiana rapper Lil Snoop, moments after hearing his demo. The label has since released mixtapes by Louis V. Guda and Lil Snoop. On June 20th, 2013, Lil Snoop was murdered at an apartment building in Winfield, Louisiana, by two gunshots to the chest. A warrant was issued for 36-year-old Tony Holden in connection with the shooting. Holden was on the run from police for 4 days before turning himself in to authorities. In late 2014, he signed his cousin and rapper, Omelli, to the imprint. On May 29, 2016, Mill signed producer Nicholas Papamitro, Nick Paps, to the label. The rapper is known for his talent and the ability to make good music, but he is also quite known for controversies and feuds with other rappers or singers. He has been arrested at various points in his life for one crime or the other. His first arrest happened when he was 18 years old. Mill was arrested for illegally possessing a firearm and assaulting a policeman when he was 18 years old. He was put on probation. In 2008, Mill was convicted of drug dealing and gun possessions and was sentenced to 11 to 23 months in prison by Judge Janice Brinkley. After Mill's 2008 conviction, Brinkley would continue to handle Mill's further legal cases. Mill was released during the early portion of 2009 under a 5-year parole agreement. In December 2012, Mill was found to have violated his probation and the judge revoked Mill's travel permit. In May 2013, Mill was again found to have violated his probation and was ordered to take adequate classes by Brinkley. The violation was a failure to report travel plans as required, and social media postings have resulted in death threats to the judge, assistant district attorney, and probation officer assigned his case. In requiring the classes and stressing the requirement to report travel, Brinkley noted, "You need to try to get this right next time." In June 2013, the court noted that Mill continually failed to report his travel plans. Brinkley established an August deadline for the classes, noting that Mill has a lot of issues, and that the classes would provide him with a big picture perspective of his personal and professional actions. Brinkley stated that these were more important than any concerts he might have. Of the requirement to provide travel plans to his probation officer, Mill complained, "You're just gonna miss money all day." The ADA explained that it was a consequence of being on probation. On July 11, 2014, Mill had his probation revoked and he was sentenced to 3 to 6 months in jail. He was released from prison on December 2, 2014. He was found guilty for a parole violation again on December 17, 2015. The judge hearing his case refused to give him another chance and ordered him to not work or perform before his sentencing on February 5, 2016. He was sentenced to 90 days of house arrest on February 5th. The sentence became effective on March 1st, during which he was not allowed to work and was required to do daily community service with groups serving adults. Additionally, he was also sentenced to 6 more years of probation. On June 2nd, 2016, Meek Mill was sentenced to 8 additional days of house arrest. His house arrest came to an end in mid-June 2016. On March 11, 2017, Mill was arrested at a local airport in St. Louis, Missouri, for assaulting two pedestrians. Shortly after his arrest and court appearance, he was given a court summons. On November 6, 2017, he was sentenced to 2 to 4 years in state prison for violating his parole. Reports allege that there was an investigation by the FBI into the conduct of the judge presiding over his case, Judge Brinkley. This came after the judge made a series of highly unusual requests in the case, including that he drop his current management team, Roc Nation, and sign with Philadelphia-born manager Charlie Mack. Undercover agents were attending the court sessions in Mill's case, suspecting links between Brinkley and Mack. The rapper's legal team launched a campaign for Brinkley to be recused from the case. In addition to a motion seeking his immediate release from prison and his probation to be terminated. In February of 2018, the officer of Mill's original 2007 case was brought under scrutiny for his potential mishandling of his arrest. This comes upon a whistleblower's testimony, responsible for the revelation of hundreds of other corrupt officers. An appeal to reverse Mill's conviction was submitted. On April 21, 2018, Mill was released pending the outcome of the appeal to the Pennsylvania Supreme Court. The Philadelphia District Attorney had petitioned Judge Brinkley for his release, citing credibility issues with the arresting officer in his initial 2008 conviction. Brinkley had declined and instead scheduled the case for a hearing. Mill was finally released from prison on April 21st, 2018, after being granted bail. Hours after his release, Rubin took the rapper to 76ers basketball game at Wells Fargo Center by helicopter. Garnering support from other public figures such as Jay-Z and Kevin Hart, Mill was stated that he would like to use his situation to shine a light on the criminal justice system. With Mill's continuous arrest and the probation from Judge Brinkley, he is estimated by his booking agency and management to have lost millions of dollars in profit. As of April 25th, 2018, Brinkley continues to handle Mill's legal cases. On November 29th, 2017, Meek Mill and Roc Nation were sued by the family of Jaquan Graves, who was shot and killed in the parking lot outside of a Connecticut concert in December 2016. Graves had just left the facility when gunfire started and he was killed. The lawsuit also claimed that Meek and Roc Nation allowed thugs to remain on the premises after exhibiting disorderly, disruptive, argumentative, angry, and agitated behavior towards patrons. Meek's release of his single, Dreams and Nightmares, brought him a lot of love and respect from his fans, but a pastor from Philadelphia accused Meek of showing religion in a bad light, in lyrics of Amen, a song from the album. On July 17th, Meek later said in an interview on The Bet Show in 106 in Park, that it was a rap song and there was always a lot of bad stuff said in rap music, and added that he did not want to hurt no religious sentiment and just wrote what he felt like in that moment. American rappers are quite well known for the feuds they indulge in from time to time. Meek also has his fair share of it. A feud started between Meek Mill and fellow Philadelphia-born rapper Cassidy when Mill offered to battle several underground rappers, including Cassidy. Cassidy would later accept the challenge, adding if the money was right. They participated in a short social exchange, after which Cassidy released The Diary of a Hustler, which was originally thought to be a diss track towards Mill. This was later refuted by Cassidy. They both asked $100,000 each for the battle to take place. However, after Meek Mill dissed Cassidy's song, Condom Style, a remake of Psy's Gangnam Style, Cassidy released a formal diss track towards Mill with the Me, Myself, and iPhone. Afterwards, Meek Mill responded with the diss track Repo, which Mill later said would be the final diss record he would release against Cassidy. Cassidy later said the feud was not personal, saying that it was all in the spirit of hip-hop. On January 6, 2013, Cassidy released a 10-minute long diss response titled Raid. 8 months later, on September 5, 2013, Meek Mill released another diss record towards Cassidy titled Kendrick, You Next. This was despite the fact that he said Repo would be his final diss record. 3 days later, Cassidy released a diss record titled Catch a Body as a response. Since then, their feud seemed to have calmed down. In July 2015, Meek Mill publicly criticized Canadian Toronto-based entertainer Drake on Twitter, calling him out for not writing his own lyrics. In a series of tweets, the rapper claimed his counterpart used a ghostwriter for Rico, a song of Mill's second album, Drums Worth More Than Money. He also admitted that he was upset that Drake didn't promote the album on Twitter upon its release. Stop comparing Drake to me. He don't write his own raps. That's why he ain't tweet my album because we found out, Meek Mill commented. Meek Mill had identified the ghostwriter as Quentin Miller, a local rapper from Atlanta. Meek Mill's claims received support from Funkmaster Flex, an American hip-hop DJ on New York City's Hot 97 radio station. Flex received multiple audio recordings of reference tracks featuring Quentin Miller performing the Drake songs, 10 Bands, Used to Know, Know Yourself, and his guest verse on Rico. Drake was later supported by his longtime friend, collaborator, and co-founder of OVO Sound, award-winning multi-platinum selling producer, 40, who claimed that not only does Drake write his own songs, he has also written number one records for other artists. No one is as talented as Drake. There are countless number ones in songs Drake has written for others, never mind himself, 40 said on Twitter. On July 25th, 2015, Drake premiered a track titled Charged Up on the Beats 1 OVO radio show that is widely seen as a response to Meek Mill's allegations. Drake highlighted Meek Mill's relatively low sales volume and further claimed that the rapper was fading into obscurity. Drake also dissed Funkmaster Flex by promoting his rival DJ Clue. On July 29th, Drake released an aggressive diss track named Back to Back that further attacked Meek Mill. The track streamed over 500,000 times in 4 hours, heavily suggesting that Mill's relationship with Nicki Minaj is lopsided in the latter's favor, and also criticized the former for not responding to Charged Up and for heavily relying on Twitter to attack Drake. The track was released for streaming on the OVO SoundCloud account and on Apple Music. The next day, Meek Mill released a track attacking Drake titled 1-0 through Funkmaster Flex on Hot 97. On 1-0, Meek Mill revealed another reference track, Ghost, written by Quentin Miller for Drake, who he criticized for being soft. Meek Mill also dissed ARAB on the track, and furthermore claimed that Drake was urinated on inside a movie theater. Mill then removed the song from SoundCloud and said that he was moving on from his feud with Drake. On January 30th, 2016, Drake released a new diss track aimed at Mill titled Summer 16 as the buzz angle used to promote his fourth album, Views. Less than 15 minutes later, Mill released a response track with label mate O'Malley called War Pain. The track references several lines from Summer 16, including an incident in which Drake played back-to-back in a public hotel, in which he had a room directly above Mill. 4 months later, Mill released a remix of Fat Joe and Remy Ma's All The Way Up with fellow rappers Fabulous and Jada Kiss. Meek directly references Drake in several lines for the song, such as, "If you don't write it, don't record it." He also implied that he was in a relationship with Drake's current love, Rihanna. Meek Mill and Drake were both respectively endorsed by Burger King and Whataburger for their feud. On September 16, 2016, The Game released a 5-minute freestyle, 92 bars, which was rumored to be a diss towards Meek Mill. Previously, Mill and The Game collaborated on 2015's The Soundtrack. Hours after the release of 92 Bars, Game admitted that the freestyle was specifically a diss towards Mill. The next day, the two rappers ended up in an Instagram exchange, with The Game cyber-flirting with Meek Mill's girlfriend, Nicki Minaj, as well as accusing him of calling the police, informing the authorities about a robbery involving Sing Kingston. On September 23rd, The Game released another diss track towards Mill, Pest Control. 10 hours later, Meek Mill released the remix of Young M.A.'s Awu. A dispute between Meek Mill and fellow Philadelphia-based rapper Beanie Siegel ensued on September 26, 2016, when the latter ridiculed the former's intelligence towards him through a radio interview. Minutes after the interview, Siegel was punched on the back of his head by whoever was believed to have been one of Meek Mill's affiliates. Then, 3 days later, Mill criticized Siegel through many derogatory messages via Instagram. Later, Mill dissed Siegel, The Game, and Drake in a freestyle on Funkmaster Flex radio show. Siegel responded by releasing a diss track titled, I'm Coming. In August 2013, Kendrick Lamar dissed Meek Mill, J. Cole, Big Crit, Whale, Pusha T, A$AP Rocky, Drake, Big Sean, J. Electronica, Tyler, the Creator, and Mac Miller on his guest verse on Big Sean's Control. Lamar touted himself to becoming the king of both coasts and threatened to murder the rappers that he mentioned before, despite being associated with them before. During a performance at a music festival in New York City, Mill sent derogatory messages towards Lamar. On September 9, 2013, Mill later released Oh Kill Them, a response to Lamar's verse in Control. In October 2013, Mill ran into a social fight with fellow Mindback music group artist Whale for not backing him up on his feud with Cassidy. Hence the fact that the latter dissed Whale and several others, with whom Mill affiliated with. He also criticized Whale for not helping him support his second studio album. 2 years later, their dispute reignited after Whale sided with another of Mill's rivals, Drake. After a long talk with mentor Rick Ross, the three paired for Make It Work, which was released on July 8, 2016. Mill's dispute with ARAB ensued after former rival Drake referenced the latter on his song Back to Back, where he plays, I waited 4 days inward, where y'all at? I drove here in the Wraith playing ARAB. ARAB later appeared on Vlad TV in August 2015, saying that he wasn't signed to Drake OVO Sound and sided with him. He was also disappointed at Mill's response, since he called out ARAB on 1-0, the response to Drake's diss track. Mill responded on August 6 during a performance at the BB&T Pavilion in Camden, New Jersey, where he said fuck ARAB and questioned his allegiance to an out-of-town rapper. ARAB responded by releasing his own version of Back to Back on August 8th, which disses Mill but also contained violent lyrics where he threatened to unleash his shooters upon Mill. In response, Meek's cousin and Dream Chaser signee O'Malley released his own version of Back to Back, which disses ARAB. ARAB did another interview on Vlad TV, where he said Mill was too scared to respond himself, and O'Malley was the softest one on the Dream Chasers. He also told that he won't respond to O'Malley's diss because he's a worker. In January 2016, ARAB revealed that he and Mill had talked it out and their feud was now over. On January 25th, 2016, Mill dissed his record label boss Rick Ross's long-term nemesis, 50 Cent, through his extended play, 4/4, not counting the remix to Drake and Future's I'm the Plug. After hearing the EP, 50 Cent replied with a set of over 22 memes, including one where he said that he should run to his girlfriend at the time, Nicki Minaj, and cry to her. With the fact that both Minaj and 50 are based from the same city, Jamaica, Queens, New York, Mill, careless, disparaged 50 Cent unkindly with a direct message, ridiculing his case involving Rick Ross's ex-girlfriend, following up by his bankruptcy case. On January 30th, 2016, Mill dissed 50 again on War Pain, in the middle of his verse saying, "My Philly boys will creep up on you when you ain't looking, with your little memes." The next day, 50 and many members of his collective G-Unit counter dissed Mill at a concert. The conflict between Meek Mill and 50 Cent also reignited the feud between the latter and Mill's mentor, Rick Ross. On June 30th, 2016, Joe Budden dissed Meek Mill and Drake on Making a Murderer, Part 1, a counter diss to the latter's 4 p.m. in Calabasas, as well as his guest verse to French Montana's No Shopping. Following his release from his 3-to-6-month prison sentence for probation violation on December 2nd, 2014, Mill began dating rapper and singer Nicki Minaj in early 2015. He accompanied her as an opening act on her 2015 world tour. On January 2nd, 2017, it was reported that Meek Mill and Nicki Minaj had ended their 2-year relationship. Their breakup is furthermore detailed in Minaj's 2017 single, Regret in Your Tears. While shopping in Maxfield, Mill was involved in a verbal altercation with Minaj and her husband, Kenneth Petty, before he was escorted out of the store. The issue resulted in a Twitter exchange between Mill and Minaj highlighting a series of abuse allegations by both parties. Meek has 3 children. His last child was by his then girlfriend, Milan Ruse. She gave birth to his second child on his 33rd birthday. That's all I have for you today. If you enjoyed watching the video, go ahead and demolish that like button. Then, like I said earlier, tell me in the comment section what rapper or issues in the music industry you would want to see me make videos about. Finally, don't forget to smash the red subscribe button and hit the notification button so that you'll get notified when we drop a video on the topic you requested. With all that said, I'll see you in the next video. Let's go!